This is handmade quality stuff and the price comes from materials, time, and stitch. But I can get a knit blanket at Walmart for 20 bucks. So why don't you just get it at Walmart then? Hello Redditors of the internet, Noble Xenon here and welcome to r/ChoosingBeggars part 46. Let's get started. Now we have choosing beggar parents who just had to ruin it for the rest of the parents because they complained about free portion sizes. Michelin starred chef's takeaway acts as free kids meals and blasts unappreciative parents. It's absolutely disgusting. No respect and no appreciation for what I do for kids in these times. The owner of a new takeaway in Whitley, or at least I think that's how it's pronounced, has stopped giving away free meals to kids after fussy parents complained about the size of them and demanded more, even though it's free. Food that was literally cooked by Danny DeVito's former personal chef. Wow. Okay then. This next one could have the house paid off in just 125 years. What a deal. How much is it to buy? $299,000. Could we give $200 a month for it till we get paid for? We have a 1-month-old baby. Even with a hefty down payment, it would still make no sense. For this next one, self-published author here, not a lot of money to spend. This person wants a free copy of my book to review, but I said I could send a free PDF copy. Here was their response. It just frustrates me that people want free stuff without knowing all the work that goes behind it. Hey, would you like to collaborate? Hello, how are you, and in what way would you want to collaborate? Fine, thanks. If you want, send me your book and I'll talk about it on my page. Do you think you could fill out the form registering to be a reviewer in order to get a free PDF copy? Thanks. Only physical, please. I'm sorry, but I don't have the money to spend like that. I do have the PDF copy to offer, but I can't spend money I don't have. You're literally being offered the book for free! What more do you want? 1 star, this app is so bad, you can watch just 6 seasons. 6 whole seasons for free and you want to complain? And now, we have Jake Paul, the choosiest of them all. If you are a young aspiring music producer and engineer, please read. We are in need of a full-time in-house producer slash engineer who will mainly act as an engineer for us. This will be an internship position and will provide you with real life experience, connections, exposure, and a whole lot of fun. We want a hard-working person who's proficient in recording on all softwares. Pro Tools, Logic, FL, Ableton, etc. Serious inquiries only, please email engineer@jakepaul.com with your Instagram, something about you, and your location doesn't matter. And now we have an acrylic nail maker slash seller on Instagram who's had enough of the choosing beggars. Afternoon all, so I received this message from a random girl on Instagram today asking me to send her free nails so she could promote my page. To which I declined and got a rude reply from her. I've received many of these messages, so please, if you're reading this and call yourself a promoter or influencer, please do not message me asking for free anything. It costs me to make nails. I don't get my supplies for free. I work full time and I'm trying to make a success of my small business at the same time. So rather than asking for free things, I'd rather you just support my page by liking my pics, commenting, and sharing my designs. This person is probably way too busy to be dealing with choosing beggars, and way too busy to be giving away free stuff. This next one is on a sell page looking to buy an SUV for $1,000. I'm not selling anything, but I'm looking to buy a used SUV. I prefer Ford Explorer, but I'm open to Chevy Blazer or other. Must run and drive, no mechanical problems, and have current tags and inspection. Clean title a must, and no salvage or rebuilt title. I have only $1,000 in cash and have no interest in a dealership deal. No dealerships, making it very clear, no dealerships. Let me see what you got. I'm motivated to buy today. All I can say is good luck with that. This next one's titled, Give Me a Code or Die. Someone give me an Uber Eats, Deliveroo, or Just Eat discount code now, or else. And not a soul commented or liked or retweeted. So then the choosing beggar replies, you can all drop dead by the way. No need to be so aggressive. Now, choosing beggar Max leaves a 1-star review. the worst delivery experience of my life. After an hour and 40 minutes, they delivered the soggiest pizza I've ever seen on a sandwich that was so soggy too, and forgot the salad. They acted like if it was no big deal. And the owner responds, "We did not forget your salad. You called back to add it to your order and then didn't want to pay for it. So we decided not to send you a free salad. Then, after you called back for the fourth time to complain, we remade your pizza for free and delivered it to you for free on an extremely busy Friday night. No mention of that at all in your review. You are welcome for the amazingly delicious, non-soggy, free replacement pizza. And to top it off, you sent my manager a very nasty verbal message through our delivery driver. Super mature of you, as well as threatening to our amazing young woman/manager that had to put up with your antics for hours. So if you're reading this review as a potential customer, I apologize. I do not usually give someone like Jet, not his real name by the way, this much airtime, but there are always two sides to every story. Peace out." This next one's a short story by Koi1212 titled, "Only If It's Free." Happened 30 seconds ago and I'm still shaking my head. So you were typing away on your phone just seconds after this happened? That is some dedication to Reddit karma right there. Anyway, walked into Krispy Kreme Donuts and there were two guys who wanted donuts, but only if they were free. The cashier looked at them and then to me and said they did away with that in March. Wait, they were giving away free donuts? They looked at me as I decided what I wanted and turned the puppy dog eyes on me, thinking I would pity them and buy them a donut. Sorry, pumpkins, if my 8-year-old can't use guilt, what makes you think you two can? This next one is looking for Ink Master quality tattoos, but wait until you look at the price. Looking for the best tattoo artist around, like Ink Master good. I have an idea for a sick full back Tiger Skidoo Racer cover-up piece. Looking for a tat master that's the best and can do it cheap. Not interested in a waiting list. I want it tomorrow at the latest. Must be Ink Master good only and willing to come to my house to do it. We'll trade hour for hour snow shoveling and crack filling. And the price? $60. Yeah, you're not getting that for $60. Now, how are my kids supposed to live without juice? The nectar of the gods! Seriously? With the thousands upon thousands of dollars being raised and food being collected, this is what the Fredericton Food Bank gave us for Christmas dinner? I am stunned. Not even a bottle of juice for my children? Please don't get me wrong, I'm forever grateful to have the resource of the food bank. Well, it doesn't sound like you're very grateful, but I want to know where all that money and food went to. A turkey, a 5-pound bag of potatoes, 2 boxes of stuffing, a bag of carrots, a bag of apples, and a bag of oranges, 1 can of string beans, 1 can of cranberry sauce, and a loaf of bread, 1 box of chocolates, and a dozen sugar cookies. Why didn't we even get juice or butter? I don't know about you, but if I was in an incredibly tough spot struggling, I would be so thankful to get this food. Now we have a Facebook choosing beggar selling a secondhand Ring doorbell for £11 more than it costs brand new from Ring, and you have to fit hers when you collect. Bought 2, only need 1. Could you fit mine when you come, please? 1nd generation, not 1st or 2nd, or is that ferned or whatever? And you see from the official Ring website, £89 for a 2nd generation video doorbell, not whatever a 1nd generation is. For this next one, I'll just pay for my whole wedding with experience points, same person on both posts. Calling all florists, do you want to expand your skills in a new and fun field, meanwhile gaining valuable experience? Do you know what else is valuable? Money. I have a one-of-a-lifetime opportunity for you to work with these amazing solo wood flowers. I'm looking for someone to make some beautiful bouquet for my wedding. I will provide all of the supplies and you provide your skills. This is solely for you to expand your skills and gain valuable experience in a new and unique field. Therefore, I'm not able to provide any additional monetary compensation. Contact me directly if you're interested. And the other one? Hi friends, I'll be getting married on July 14th of this year. If you're starting out photographer looking for field and hands-on experience, then you're more than welcome to join my wedding and take all the pictures you want for your portfolio. I will not be able to provide any compensation because I already have a professional photographer scheduled. So why the call for exposure then? All I'm asking in return is to have copies of all the photos. They don't have to be edited. You can come at any time and stay for as long as you want. If this is something that's of an interest to you, contact me directly or tag your friends. Now that I think about it, I bet there's not actually a professional photographer. This person wants the whole wedding for free. This next one is looking for a room for my daughter. She's employed and has been so throughout the entire pandemic. She is leaving her husband and needs something immediately in a quiet home. She does love to listen to her music loudly when getting ready for work, and she leaves for work at 4 or 4:30 a.m. every single morning. Also, she has a fear of dogs. If anyone knows of anything, please inbox me. Now let me get this straight. Your daughter's playing music loudly at 4 or 4:30 every single morning when most people are still sleeping? Has she heard of headphones? And now we've got a gal in her late 50s and talking to me, someone half her age. OP starts us off. Hey, I saw your comment on my post and thought it might be better to privately message you. I typically charge $50 a lesson and the lessons are in and near your home. You get 1 hour of one-on-one teaching, hands-on learning, and a plan/write-up within a week of the end of the lesson. Choosing Beggar replies. Hi, love that you have a plan and write-up after just one lesson. I had a trainer for 2 months and I never got anything close to that. I finally let her go this week. I have a 3-year-old 90-pound horse of a Labrador. He is a lot to handle. Main issue is how crazed he gets when he greets people. So I don't have anyone over or I put him in the car. So, I'm on SSDI, which are basically disability benefits, and only pulling $900 a month. So do you do a sliding scale based on income? I'm just going to ask, and it's okay if it's a no. Would you consider doing that for $30? It never hurts to ask. No response, that's not a good sign of integrity. OP replies, actually Martha, I just got home from work. I've been at work all day. I'd really love to help you out with your lab, but I have to stay true to my prices. I'm sorry. Beggar replies, wow, that says a lot. You're more about money than really being serious about animals. Shame on you, especially in these times. Best if you don't respond. Because I have to work to live? I work for someone else making money. I'm not more about money at all. I'm more about making a living and surviving. Beggar replies, no, about not having a sliding scale, because maybe COVID took away their job, meaning me? Forget it. Sorry for whatever's my fault, I have to move on. OP replies, if you want to spin it that way, you clearly said it's okay if it's a no. So it's a no from me, thank you for asking. Beggar finally replies, yeah, that's clearly the best way to spin it with an upside down face. I can tell you're a frickin' don't respond, or I'll really have to get nasty. And a couple of emojis with hearts and a halo at the end. We go to Twitter for this next one. The investing world is full of choosing beggars. I think I'm gonna institute a new rule on my Twitter feed. For now on, I'll block anyone that makes the ridiculous statement that because I'm successful, I should work for free and give away my products and services. Did Steve Jobs have to put up with this BS? For this next one, can't even imagine the amount of BS they had to take to get to this point. We do not accept the following. IOUs, I got yous, I get paid in a weeks, or can you hook it up this time, bro? And for this last one, guess there was one influencer too much asking a small business for free stuff. Please stop asking us for cooperations and free products. At the moment, we are fighting to keep our brand alive. We are working very hard to produce special products for you. Yes, your pictures may be great, and yes, you also put a lot of effort into it, but they can't pay the bills. If you really like our products, then order them. Or there is no brand left to promote next year. Thank you for understanding. Ah yes, people asking for free stuff. Even though small businesses are already struggling out here, they just can't afford to give away free stuff. Anyway, I'd like to thank all of my patrons, especially Benjamin Spoonie the Rogue, Seth Southwell, Catalin Cormendi, and Henrik GF Mickelson. You can join in the link below, and thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like. If you have something interesting to say, don't forget to comment. And if you want to see more, don't forget to subscribe and hit the little notification bell. See you guys next time.